Hi, my name is Chris from learngrasshopper.com. The number of components in Grasshopper is enormous. With additional packages, there are loads of them. On the one hand, it's a tremendous advantage of Grasshopper. You can do whatever you like in this program. Lots of transformations, conversions, operations, you name it. On the other hand, it is challenging to learn all of them, grasp all names, memorize where to find them, and know the actual function with the all inputs and outputs. In this series, I will show you the components that I consider helpful and worth knowing. Enjoy the video! Right trigonometry. This is a component for all those who do not like math. Easy to use component calculates for you all dependencies of angles and length of the triangle edges. To get results in the output, you have to insert just two datas as an input. Rest component will calculate for you. Remember that you have to convert values from degrees into radians. Handy component that will prevent you from making a mistake in angle calculations. Concatenate. This component connects some fragments of a text. With the pluses at the top and bottom, you can add more text fragments. If you will add a list of numbers, you will get a list of connected fragments. Moreover, you can use a split text component and divide your whole text into two lists. List indicates. This component is available in the Pufferfish plugin. Connecting a list to it will result in a list of indicates. In the other words, get a list of the indicates from a list of items. How it can be used? For example, to visualize data with the correct numbers or set up layers numbers. Indicates will present order of items and you can bake data in numbered Rhino layers. If you would like to learn and read more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free Grasshopper guide. 20 pages filled with books, exercises and tutorials about Grasshopper. Everyone will find something for themselves. To download the guide, please click the link in the description below.
Gradient. One of the things we can do to visualize the list data is to assign color to the geometry. Grasshopper has limited rendering capabilities, but we can control simple settings like color, specular color, transparency, and etc. Example shows colorizing panels regarding to the z-coordinate of the panel center. The L0 value represents the gradient's low end, left side, whereas the L1 value represents the upper end, right side. These values correspond to the start and end of our domain, minimum and maximum value. The T values are the elements in the list that will get mapped somewhere within the L0 and L1 range. Right-click on the gradient to set one of the gradients present, or define your own using the color node points. Data dam can temporarily prevent the flow of the data from the left side to the right until it's clicked. If you have a definition that takes a lot of time to calculate on the right side of the data dam, changing the left side parameters may cause the whole task to be delayed or even shut down your machine. It is possible to block your wires completely or delay flow just for some seconds. Example shows that the geometry of a mesh was changed and the colors were adjusted to the new geometry after starting the data dam.
To be updated and to learn all secrets and Grasshopper components, join our community. It's easy. Go to learngrasshopper.com, click the join button, write your email address and click the confirmation link in the email you will get from me. Every week, you will be getting all the latest videos, learning materials and inspiring links about Grasshopper directly to your inbox. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Have a good one.